हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू ऑल. माय नेम इज अरविंद राय फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल व्हिच इज सिचुएटेड इन गोला बाजार गोरखपुर एंड आई एम अ सब्जेक्ट टीचर ऑफ सोशल स्टडीज एंड दिस वीडियो इज फॉर क्लास फिफ्थ स्टूडेंट्स. स्टूडेंट्स इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सम न्यू टॉपिक्स ओके अंडर द चैप्टर द हॉट एंड वेट इक्वेटोरियल रीजन. Hot and wet equatorial region. Okay. So our chapter name is the hot and wet equatorial region. And in our previous video, I discussed that what are the different topics, okay, which we are going to cover in this chapter, and what we are going to be able to describe after the completion of this chapter, okay. Now we will start the chapter. See on page number 25. In the last chapter, you read about the three main heat zones of the world. In the last chapter, you read about the three main heat zones of the world: torrid, temperate, and frigid. Okay, these are the three heat zones of the world. After that, within these broad bands are several smaller climate regions. Since climate influences the kind of plant and animal species or life found in a region, each of these regions has a unique plant and animal life. Okay, climate also influences the lives of the people living in these regions. Thus, the clothes people wear, the crops they grow, the food they eat, their occupations, all vary from one climate region to the other. We will look at life in a few of the climatic regions of this year. In this chapter, we will study the hot and wet equatorial region. Okay, students, as we had read earlier that our earth, or we can say our world, is divided into three heat zones. Okay, first one is torrid, second one is temperate, and third one is frigid zone. Okay, under these vast bands, okay, under these big climatic regions, there are some smaller climatic regions which are divided throughout the world. Okay, what does it means? In world, we have different small climatic regions, and that every climatic regions vary from each other on the basis of the types of crops that are grown there, the types of clothes that are getting wear by the people who are living there, okay, types of languages, types of living standards, they all vary from each climatic region to other. Okay, after this, in this chapter we are going to read about the hot and wet equatorial region. Okay, so the first topic is location. First topic is location. Okay, what is the location of the hot and wet equatorial region? The hot and wet equatorial climate region lies within the torrid zone and extends 10 degree north and south of the equator. Okay, what does it means? Suppose we are having this line of equator, okay, this is line of equator which divides the earth into two equal parts, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Okay, so in this chapter we are talking about the location of the hot and wet equatorial region. Okay, so
The location of the hot and wet equatorial region is 10 degree north and south of the equator. Okay, 10 degree north. Suppose you are taking this as 10 degree. Okay, and this as 10 degree. This is north and this is south. This is east and this is west. Okay, so this region. Okay, these two particular regions we are talking about 10 degree north to the equator and 10 degree south to the equator. Okay, so this region is called the torrid zone, and this is the location of the torrid zone when we are taking the example of a globe. Okay, when we are talking about Earth, so this is the region where torrid zone lies. This is torrid zone, and this one is also torrid zone. Okay, now it is clear to you what is the location of the torrid zone. After that, it includes the Amazon basin in South America, the Democratic Republic of Congo in Africa, and Malaysia and Indonesia in Asia. Okay, it includes the Amazon basin. In torrid zone, we have Amazon basin in South America, the Democratic Republic of Congo in Africa, and Malaysia and Indonesia in Asia. Okay, after that, we'll talk about the climate of this region. What is the climate of this hot and wet equatorial region? Okay, see on page number 26, what is the climate of this region? As this region receives the direct rays of the sun, it remains hot throughout the year. There is no winter. Okay, suppose the sun rays, okay, sun rays, here we are having sun. Okay, here we are having sun, and this region, this torrid zone region, gets the direct sun rays throughout the year, and this particular region is hot. Okay, it remains hot throughout the year. There is no winter. Okay, there is no winter in this region. After that, second point is humidity is high throughout the year because of the many water bodies and dense forests found here. Okay, what is humidity? We had discussed earlier also that amount of water vapor which is present in the atmosphere, that is known as humidity. Okay, Hindi mein hum use umas kehte hain. Okay, when we are not able to breathe normally, when humidity is very much high, and chances of precipitation is also high due to humidity. So humidity is high throughout the year because of the many water bodies and dense forests found here. Okay, why humidity is very much high in this particular region? Because we have many water bodies in this region and very much dense forests. Okay, very much dense forests in this region. Dense means bahut hi ghane jangal. Theek hai, the intense heat during the day leads to rapid evaporation of water. Towering clouds form and heavy rain occurs every afternoon around 4 o'clock. The heavy rains cool the air, making the heat and humidity bearable. Okay, what happens? The intense heat during the day. Okay, jab din ke samay bahut zyada garmi padti hai, atyadhik garmi padti hai, it leads to rapid evaporation of water. Okay, the water evaporates. It goes upwards in the form of gas. Water goes
upwards in the atmosphere in the form of gas that is known as evaporation. Towering clouds form and it forms clouds, and heavy rains occurs every afternoon around 4 o'clock. ठीक है, जब बहुत घने बादल छा जाते हैं एवापोरेशन की वजह से, ठीक है, सो इट रेन्स हैविली एंड विच ऑफर्स एवरी आफ्टरनून अराउंड 4 o'clock. ठीक है, शाम के 4 बजे के समय डेली बहुत ही ज्यादा बारिश होती है. द हैवी रेन्स कूल द एयर मेकिंग द हीट एंड ह्यूमिडिटी बियरेबल. द रेनफॉल इज इवनली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड थ्रू आउट द ईयर. देयर इज नो मंथ दैट इज ड्राई. ओके, the rainfall is evenly distributed throughout the year. It means that throughout the year, okay, this region gets evenly amount of rain in every month. ठीक है, हर महीने या आप कह सकते हैं साल में बराबर तरीके से वहां पर बारिश हमेशा होती रहती है. And there is no month that is dry. और कोई भी महीना इस रीजन में ऐसा नहीं होता है जो ड्राई होता है, जहां जिस महीने में बारिश नहीं होती है. ओके, इज इट क्लियर टू यू? आफ्टर दैट नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज नेचुरल वेजिटेशन. ओके, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज नेचुरल वेजिटेशन. नेचुरल वेजिटेशन मीन्स what type of natural vegetation is found in this region. Okay, what type of plant species, okay, what type of plants, trees, they are found in this region, that is known as the natural vegetation of that particular place. Okay, so this is a wide topic, okay, which we are going to read in a detailed form, okay, in our next video. Till then you are supposed to revise each and every point what we had discussed in this video regarding the first chapter, that is location of this region and climate of this region, that is hot and wet equatorial region. Okay, and you will also maintain your fair copies as well as classwork copies. Okay, and I will provide you the exercise and written notes in the form of PDFs that you can cover each and every topics and lessons as well. Okay, thank you so much.